walks off like that without saying anything, and I never know why. Sometimes he's gone for hours at a time. He says the walk helps his digestion, but I think it's just that he wants to get away from me sometimes.
Morse is nice to you. You've got no right to complain.
He's nice to me in some ways.
My heavens, Lottie. He bought you those red patent leather slippers and that nice box neck piece. You should be grateful.
I know, but there's some things he hasn't given me.
Lottie, that's not his fault. You've got no right to hold that against him.
Oh, it's fine for you to talk. You've got two nice kids to keep you company. What have I got? A house full of cats.
But Lottie, you always said that you never wanted any children.
What else could I say to people? Cora, I can't let you and the kids come over and stay with us.
Oh, Lottie.
Oh, Cora, I just can't. I'm sorry.
I was depending on you, Lottie.
Well, maybe you've depended on me too much. Ever since you were a baby, you've come running to me with your problems, and now I've got problems of my own.
What am I going to do, Lottie?
Call Reuben and ask him to come back. Beg him if you have to. Get down on your knees.
I mustn't do that, Lottie.
Why not?
Because we can't keep from fighting, Lottie. You know that. I just don't think it's right, us going on like that. Because we can't keep from fighting, Lottie.
Well, do you still love him?
Don't ask me that, Lottie.
Do you?
Oh, yes.
Does he still want to be intimate?
That's only animal, Lottie. I could never indulge myself like that if I didn't feel he was being honorable.
A big, handsome buck like Reuben? Who cares if he's honorable?
Lottie.
Cora, did you hear what the old maid said to the burglar? The burglar came walking into her bedroom with this big, long belly club.
Lottie!
and the old maid, she was so green. She didn't know what was happening to her, and she said,
Lottie, that is enough. That's enough.
Cora, I don't see what's the problem in just having a little fun telling stories.
You sometimes talk shamefully, Lottie. And when I think about the way Mama and Papa raised us.
Mama and Papa. Maybe they didn't know as much as we gave them credit for.
You're changed since you were a girl, Lottie.
So what if I am?
I never heard such talk.
Well, that's all it is talk. Talk.
Are you sure, Lottie, you can't take us in?
It'd mean the end of my marriage too, Cora.
Honest?
I'm not joking, Cora. You're not the only one with problems, you know. Don't think that for a minute.
A few moments ago, you said you had problems, Lottie.
Problems enough.
Tell me, Lottie.
Why should I?
Doesn't Morris ever make love to you anymore?
No. It's been over 3 years since he even touched me that way.
Lottie.
Oh, fine. It's the God's truth, Cora.
Lottie, what's wrong?
How do I know what's wrong? How does anybody know what's wrong with anyone else?
I mean, is there another woman?
Not unless she's visiting him from the spirit world. No, there's not another woman. Sometimes I wish there was.
You don't mean that, Lottie.
How the hell do you know what I mean? He's in the house all day long now that he's got his dental office in the dining room. Day and night, day and night. God, sometimes I get sick of seeing him.
Lottie, I always thought that you and Morris were so devoted to one another. I thought you had an almost perfect marriage.
Well, we're still devoted. We still call each other honey, and just like we did on our honeymoon.
But what happened? Something must have happened to...
Do you know how Morris just got up and walked away without any explanation at all? Well, something inside of Morris just got up and walked away a few years ago. Just got up and walked away and never came back.
I just don't understand.
Mine, sometimes I wonder.
Sometimes I wonder, maybe I've been too bossy. I mean, it could be. But then again, I thought Morris liked me because I was bossy.
I've always envied you that you could boss your husband around.
Well, yeah, I could boss Morris because he just isn't there anymore to fight back. He just doesn't care if I boss him anymore or not.
Even still, he doesn't hit you.
I wish he would.
What? Lottie?
I do. I wish someone loved me enough to hit me. I mean, you and Reuben fight. God, I love a good fight. It'd be better than this nothing. Morris and I go around being so sweet to each other all the time, but yeah, sometimes I wonder if he wants to kill me.
You don't.
Do you remember how Mom and Papa used to caution us about men?
I remember.
Well, my God, they had me so afraid to ever give in to a man that I was petrified.
So was I.
Yes, you were. Until Reuben came along and practically raped you.
Lottie, I don't want Sonny to hear that kind of talk.
Why not? Let him hear.
Lottie!
Why do we always feel we have to protect kids?
Keep your voice down. Reuben never did anything like that.
Didn't he?
Of course not.
My God, Cora, he had you pregnant within 2 weeks of starting to see you.
Shh.
I didn't tell. I've never told. I've never even told Morris. Lime.
Do you remember how Mama and Papa carried on
about it? Like, Mom and Papa carried on about it so much.
I remember.
And Papa had a stroke not a month after the two of you were married. Oh, I just thought Reuben was the wickedest man I'd ever seen.
I never blamed Reuben for that. I was crazy in love with him. He just swept me off my feet and made all my objections seem kind of silly. Even made Mama and Papa seem kind of silly.
Maybe I should have married a man like that. I don't know. Maybe it's not just Morris's fault. Maybe it's mine that... Maybe I just didn't respond right from the very first.
What do you mean, Lottie?
Cora, I'll tell you something. Something I've never told another soul. I just never enjoyed it the way other women say they do.
What? You?
Why do you say me like that? Because I talk kind of dirty sometimes. It's, that's all it is talk. I talk all the time just to make myself feel like I'm alive and fill myself with victuals just to feel like I've got something inside of me. And, and I have all kinds of crazy ideas about all the things I feel like I've missed out on in life.
Now I'm telling you the truth.
Now I'm telling you the truth, Cora. Nothing ever really happened to me while I was going through.
So, how did that feel? As a repetition exercise, how did that feel?